As we have understood some of the basics with respect to dict, such as accessing the elements within the dict as well as manipulating the elements within the dict. Now let's see some common examples while creating dict. If you are familiar with JSON, dict is similar to JSON. If you are not familiar, don't worry too much about JSON at this time. Go through this topic and then Google around with respect to JSON. You should be able to relate both dict and JSON easily. A dict can have key value pairs where key is of any type and value is of any type. So this is dict. The name of the dict is D. The keys are nothing but ID, first name, last name, amount, and the values are nothing but 1, Scott, Tiger, and 1000 respectively. However, even though these can be of any type, typically we use attribute names as keys. So ID, first name, last name, and amount are nothing but attributes, and we will use those as keys. And these keys are typically defined as string type. When it comes to values, the values can be of simple types such as int, float, string, etc. as we have seen here, or it can be object of some custom type. So if you are using object-oriented concepts within Python, if you define classes and if you instantiate objects, you can even have those objects as part of your dict values. Also, the value of these elements within the dict can be of type list or nested dict. So this is the example for the value being list. And this is the example for the value being dict. So phone numbers is a good example for a list. Address is a good example for a nested dict. Now, when it comes to the examples, an individual might have multiple phone numbers and hence we can define it as list. An individual address might have street, city, state, and zip, and hence we can define it as nested dict. Let us see these examples in action so that you understand more about what I have highlighted earlier. So let me create this D, which is of type dict. I am iterating through all the keys in the dict and I am trying to get the type of the keys. So I am just saying for key in d.keys. D.keys will return a set like object which will contain all the keys which are nothing but ID, first name, last name and amount. In this case, I am just printing type of attribute name is whatever is the type using type function. So let me run this and you can see that ID, first name, last name and amount are of type strings. This will actually return the type of values. So in this case, 1 is of type integer, Scott is of type string, Tiger is of type string and 1000 is of type float. Now I am adding a new element to the dict. I am actually reinstantiating this dict D with phone numbers. If you want, you can also say d.update. So instead of running this, you can just ignore this and you can actually say d.update like this. As part of the update, you can add this element. Or you can also say D of phone numbers and assign a list to it. Even that one will make sure that the phone numbers element is added to the dict. I am using update here. With update, I have to pass the tuples like this. That's why it failed. So now let me fix it. So the syntax has to be like this. I have passed list of tuple. Now I can run this and then I should be able to validate D here. You can see the phone numbers in this dict. Now, if I get the type of values, the phone numbers is of type list. I can also add address to it. Instead of reinstantiating the object, I can also say D of address. Let me delete this completely. I am assigning a dict to it. We should be able to update this dict D using this approach. Now I can run this and I should be able to get the output. So I have assigned a nested dict to this address. And now if I actually try to see the output on D, this is how it will look like. So there is a nested dict for address. We have already ran D of address and we can see the output of the address. Also, we can get the type of it. Address is of type dict. You can also run this to understand the type of each and every element in this dict called as D. This is how you should be able to create dicts with different types of values. However, the keys are typically of type strings only. As we have spent enough time on fundamentals of the core data structures within Python, such as list, set, dict, and tuple, now it is time for us to explore some real-world scenarios. Let's get into those details.